is 19 Man of the Hour. You'll say any line that you want as long as not in the script. See you later in the movie tonight.
Danny, my dear king of the drama. I hate to be late, but I am so good at it. Besides, it's better to be late
than to arrive ugly.
Hey, we're trying to focus here?
Yeah, some of us actually expect to get a role in this play.
King, Danny, you ruined me. You think for one second that I don't take these auditions more seriously than I take my very life?
There's literally nothing you take seriously, Nate.
Jessica, you of all people should know that I take everything seriously. The Dunsinane Drama Club isn't really more important than the very breath of air gassing past my perfect white teeth. I'm never gonna give it up.
We all wish you would.
Never gonna let you down.
I doubt he even has a monologue memorized.
Never gonna run around and desert you.
Hey, Nate, you need to sign in if you're going to audition.
Yes, I'm auditioning. Where would this rabid rabble of swan slingers be without their fearless leader? This audition is for High School Musical, right?
Heather! I'm so glad you could come to audition.
Hey, Jessica.
What role will you be auditioning for, dear? Of course, I was just wondering, because I'm going to be auditioning for Lady Macbeth, and I would feel terrible from taking that role from you.
I'm not auditioning, Jessica.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that, Heather.
Hey, Heather.
How's it going?
I think I'm ready. I better be ready. I've read the play 50 times. When I sleep, I dream and I am a pentameter.
Let me hear your monologue.
No, no more. I think I've practiced it too much already.
What monologue are you doing?
The Queen is Dead one.
What's that one about?
Nate, have you read the play?
Eric, I'm disappointed. We've been friends for 10 years. I think by now you should know me. I never read the plays. Bad luck.
How do you memorize your lines?
He doesn't.
What monologue are you doing?
Alas, boy Hamlet!
Yorick.
What?
His name is Yorick.
No, his name's Hamlet.
No, his friend, the person he's talking about, his name is Yorick.
But he's talking about his horse.
No, oh, the skull is his friend, Yorick.
Eric, you're hilarious. Hamlet would never be friends with a skull. He's a prince. Here, check it out.
Alas, boy Hamlet, I knew him well.
Oh, Daddy, I must say, oh, dear boy, I'm gonna lose.
That's awful.
I know, but I didn't write it. Hey, my cousin found those firecrackers. Where are you doing after school?
Oh, seriously? He's been looking all week. You guys are going out tonight, are you?
Yeah, you should come.
I can't. Me and my mom are driving to Scottsdale.
Why?
She's meeting some old friends of hers.
It's gonna take all night.
2 hours drive.
What are you guys auditioning for?
What's the smallest role in the play?
I don't know, Porter maybe?
I'm definitely Porter material. I can port anything.
I'm gonna be the Mad King.
That's all I'm auditioning for.
You what?
I'm auditioning for Macbeth.
Don't say the name. It's cursed.
I'm playing that role. This is the role I'm picking this year.
That's a terrible custom.
Terrible or not, it is the custom. The president
of the drama club.
The president of the drama club gets to pick whatever role he wants. This is the one that Danny has chosen. You'll have to audition for some other role for when we get the play.
Eric can audition for whatever role he wants. If Mr. Peters doesn't like his audition, he can cast Eric in whatever role he likes. But that shouldn't stop Eric from trying out.
We all agreed to certain rules in the drama club.
Your drama club, you mean?
Maybe you should have run for president, Heather.
Eric should have. He'd be much better at it than Dan.
Whoa, everybody calm down. We have the drama club, we have a president. Who we elect?
It's not an election, it's a popularity contest.
Be that as it may, Danny is the president, and the rules say that he gets to choose one of his roles.
I'm auditioning for Macbeth.
Now you've said it twice. There's nothing.
Kick me out of your stupid club if you want to.
Eric, you're first. Mr. Peters is ready for your audition. I gotta go, Eric. Frankly.
Well, he already double dressed himself, so he might as well break both of them.
Oh, and be careful going to Scottsdale tonight. I think it's supposed to rain.
See you tomorrow.
Oh, and be sure you get that role you want, Eric.
Change your audition, Eric, or you'll regret it.
That's not gonna happen, Danny. Macbeth say, killer role.
Will you stop saying Macbeth?
Oh no. Now I'm
here.
would have been a time for such a word. Tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day to the last syllable of recorded time. And all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way to dusty death. Out, out, brief candle. Life's but a walking shadow. A poor player who struts and frets his hour upon the stage, and then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot full of sound and fury, signifying nothing.
Will you please finish now? It's distracting.
Good evening, Dunsinane. Welcome back to a brand new school year. This is your principal hoping that you had a wonderful summer. There are already a few big events to announce. This morning, the Dunsinane Drama Club held their auditions for the first play of the year. Many players came to display their talents, and I hear that the title role is somewhat contested. The play is a classic, full of violence and tragedy. It's called...
Mom, look out!
Eric!
Where shall we meet when we meet again? To meet her twice would not be safe.
The auditions are done in Hall 1. They're well meant to have our fun. Eric, King, there we'll see.
Not King yet, but soon will be.
Anon!
Demons who arrive if you dare. The lockers of ice, so do beware.
Fair is foul and foul is fair. Hover through the fog and filthy air.
He dared! The monster! His father is a salesman guy. He wears his cells in Verona Town. But like a hobo sparrow thimble, I'll make him dance, light and nimble. I'll give thee a wine, thou'rt kind.
And I another.
I myself have all the other. Tiger's finger, I am mute. Eagle's claw and pigeon's tooth. I see his father shriveled dry, and on his grave his son shall cry. First his sleep we shall take. Docility he cannot fake.
Next we shall affect his gait.
A young man with an old man's face will see him crumble like dry grass, and the boy will stand so crass. Shall on his father's grave and laugh, cry and cry, alas, alas.
Bell, bell, Eric, you've come.
We, the sisters of the God, close the problem in black hot, circle the fire round and round, dice to thine and dice again to make up mine.
Peace, the charm is well done.
Well, he laughed, which I guess is what I was going for, but Penny shook his head and said,
I told you York wasn't Hamlet's horse.
He has borne me on his back 1,000 times.
Piggyback, dude.
Okay, look,
what's this? What evil clones are these?
I know not. Be they beasts or be they students. Girls, I think. Venomous they look, in dark garb. Their nails painted the blackest black. Skin as pale as the moonlight.
Hark!
Pale figures? Why haunt you this hallway?
Hail, hail, the kings are here!
The kings are here, I have no fear!
Hail, King Eric! Hail, King Eric! Hail, King Eric and King Eric!
Why may I flatter
thee? Get back, witches!
Sweet Eric, O king, be still!
Pinch me, girls, or I make swoon!
Clever knave, who also king will be!
Pinch me, girls, or I make scream!
What dark prophecy is this? We are not kings! You are mistaken and evil, too!
Denial, he projects!
He'll see it true!
Leave, creatures of this dark hallway! Your pallid hearts are filled with soot. Leave now and you may keep your heads.
Wait, what did you mean, King Eric? I am not king, and neither is he.
One is one, plus two is three.
We've shined the truth, you soon shall see.
The king, you said that we will both be kings. That's not possible, there can't be two mad kings. Answer me, pale figures, tell me why you call us kings.
Leave them, Eric. No good can come from these evil thrones. Their prophecies will breed only evil. Their fortunes only ruination. Come, let's get back to our room.
Are you riding with us, ma'am?
Yes, I'm riding with you. I'm sorry, please, can we hurry?
As the moonlight, their lips as dark as their souls. Thou, creatures of the night.
Gods.
Yes.
I haven't seen one of their kind in many years.
They seem to have returned. They spoke to us.
What did they say?
Nonsense, they're gods.
Gods are soothsayers. They speak in rules, but they always know the future.
Then rejoice. They said I will be king.
Are you serious?
Oh, you don't believe that, do you?
I believe this.
What is that?
An invitation from Jessica and Danny. They want us to meet them for lunch to discuss a promotion.
Let me see it.
They want you to be vice president of the drama club.
But why?
Not why, but how. The soothsayers, the gods. They predict that you will be here now. An opportunity presents itself. The question isn't why are they promoting you, but how do we make the gods already come to pass?
What do you mean?
If you are vice president, then there will only be one person standing between you and the presidency. After he's gone, there will be nothing to stop him from taking the role of king.
Regicide?
Yes.
But wait, the gods, they also said that Nate will be king.
Nate? Are you sure?
Yes.
Then he will have to be dealt with as well.
He's my friend. We've been friends since preschool.
Eric, you need to make a decision. What's more important to you, one friend or the role of king?
I'll banish him instead. Send him to Verona.
Eric, you cannot let him live. The suit says. find out whether they're friends, and then we want only the best for them and the drama club. Just say the words. You don't have to mean them.
We'll be like ashes in my mouth.
Eric! Heather! Come in! Glad you could join us.
Thank you so much for the invitation.
And for the promotion. It is a great honor. Please, sit down. You're part of the family now.
I'll get you lunch.
That's okay. We're not hungry.
Big breakfast. That's all right. We're mostly glad you could come and meet with us. Well, I have to say, Eric, it's a great honor to promote you. You're an excellent actor and a very decent person.
Thank you. Though it was a surprise.
Well, I realize that you haven't been treated fairly. You've been a huge part of our drama club, and actually never being considered one as a position. It wasn't really fair.
And the position opened up?
It did, and thank goodness it did. Now I have the paperwork right here. Now, of course that you're vice president of the drama club, you'll take all our rules seriously.
Of course.
And our customs as well. You're going to have to see Mr. Peters after lunch and tell him that you won't be playing the Mad King after all.
That's why you're doing this?
Eric!
You want me to give up the role.
No, you misunderstand. I'm doing this because you'll make an excellent vice president. Secondary, you'll have to be an earnest member of our drama club, and no rule breaking and no stopping at our custom. Can you do that, Eric?
Eric.
Of course.
Now, I brought a present to commemorate this promotion. It's our custom. I had this for 2 years.
Is this the dagger which I see before me? The handle towards my hand?
This is Carnwenna. I had this when I was King Arthur. It's yours now.
I have thee not. And yet I see thee.
Eric!
Eric, I'll hold on to that for you.
A dagger of the mind? A false creation?
It's been a rough morning. His mind has not been his own since he heard of his promotion. Thank you very much for this lovely and heartfelt gift.
It's my pleasure. Thank you for meeting with us.
Eric, I think the bell will be ringing soon. We should be going. We would both like to sincerely thank you once again from the bottom of our hearts for providing Eric with this opportunity. We are indebted to your kindness and look forward to showing you that he deserves it.
King is no more. Danby was the shining light of the halls of Dunsinane, and now
his life has been extinguished. May we remember him and Jessica and Malcolm forever with kindness in our hearts.
Hear, hear.
But as you also know, the Dunsinane Drama Club must soldier on into its bright future.
Hear, hear.
As Vice President, I must now continue on in Danny's place as President. And take the role of King.
The King is dead.
Long live the King!
Thank you all for being here for my coronation. Now, let us try to enjoy ourselves.
Long live the King!
Where's Lady Heather?
She's locked herself in the girls' locker room, Your Grace. She won't come out. She screams and marches about. She speaks of the spirits and the dead, and then she talks about blood on her hands.
She should be here.
I told her that, sir.
Go and make sure she's all right.
Mr. President?
I'm the King now.
You're the King, miss.
Is your job accomplished?
Student, the one you sent me after?
Nate.
Aye. I think he's left the school.
Was it early dismissal?
Nate, I checked the office. He's unenrolled.
You had one job! Get out! What's this? Who are you? Why are you standing there? Speak up! What do you have to say for yourself?
What are you talking to, Eric?
You there, behind my seat, who... Danny! What are you doing here? Stop! You're dead! Put that hand down! Why are you pointing at me?
No one there, Eric.
No one? No one else can see this pale, deathly vision?
Eric, you need to wake up.
Eric,
please, it's important.
Why is this happening? What have I done? They're coming for me. The ghosts are coming for me. I must see the ghosts. They will tell me my fate. I must protect myself. Second told me have no fear. I should only fear a 3-year-old child. a 3-year-old child, then I have nothing to fear from Nate.
There's more, Eric.
Eric, listen, if you can hear me, you need to...
Do not listen to these voices!
Eric, you need to wake up.
They only wish your mind to poison!
They're going to have to turn off the...
Double, double!
Wait, I know that voice!
Burn the trouble!
I can burn a potion bubble!
Eric, fear not your future as king. Your reign shall last until tigers roam the halls of Dunsinane.
Tigers in the halls of Dunsinane? That will never happen. The first one told me to fear Nate. The second one told me to only fear a 3-year-old child. The third told me that I shall reign as king until tigers walk the halls of the school. But what of Nate? You said before that he shall be king.
See no, no more!
In the ruins of life's rubble,
you sought the truth, and its trouble,
double, double, toil and trouble.
And through venues and pops and bubbles,
tiger paw, young boy's fate, no trouble for you, champion Nate.
Double, double,
toil and trouble,
bring the future on the double.
Come for me, I see.
done.
The Goths were right. They were right that I would be king.
They also said I would be the king.
Well, that was a lie.
Your mom asked me to come. I wanted to see you.
My mom?
Was...
You turned on your own people, Eric. We were friends.
Kings don't have friends.
You're turning off the machines today, Eric.
Shut up!
I don't want to do this, Eric.
Try it! You can't hurt me, Nate. The Goth said that the only person I should fear is a three-year-old child. You didn't bring me three-year-olds, did you, Nate?
You never remember my birthday, do you, Eric? Every single year you forget.
What are you talking about?
Maybe you'll remember it after today. February 29th, leap day. I've only had three birthdays. I am your three-year-old.
Ah! 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 Ah!
Patient Eric Watson died of complications from accidental trauma. November 30th, 11:58 a.m.
King is
I'm so sorry, Eric.